Yes.
Okay, thank you. Okay, assalamualaikum and a very good morning to all students of Four Arcade, boys and girls. So I hope you are in a good condition there. So this will be our lesson today, content standard 5.7, electromagnetic wave. So we have finished with 5.6. So I hope you are doing well with interference. Any problem with interference so far? Do you think you can deal with interference? So I have given you all the answers for the exercises in your workbook for interference, starting from page 147 until 154. So I hope everyone have completed, okay, the exercises. Okay, now, so let's begin with our final content standard on chapter 5. This is electromagnetic wave. Okay. So have you learned electromagnetic wave before? You learn them in Form 3, yes, if I'm not mistaken. Is it correct or not?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so what do you remember about electromagnetic wave, sine wave?
Gamma ray.
Anything? Gamma ray. Okay, any more? Okay, how about the rest of you? Anything you remember about electromagnetic wave? Gamma ray is part of electromagnetic wave, yes. Anything else? How about others? Anything you remember about electromagnetic wave? How about Vincent, Kafai, Tunchuan, Jiayi, Yuqian, Tison, Ongjeng, Shamel, anything? Eating? Okay, so let us check what is electromagnetic wave refers to, okay? Okay, so in this content standard 5.7, there are three learning standard only, which is very simple and short. The first one, 5.7.1, each and every one of you must know how to characterize electromagnetic wave. Okay, what is electromagnetic wave? So let us take a look at the history first on the development of electromagnetic waves. So these are all the physicists who are help us a lot, okay, in understanding electromagnetic wave. Okay, the first one, okay, electromagnetic wave introduced by Thomas Young in 1801 when he is conducted an experiment on double slit experiment. Okay, so in Young double slit experiment, which we discussed earlier in interference of wave, if you remember interference of light, which passed through double slit. So Thomas Young shows that light is a wave. Okay, so from the experiment, he has proved that light is a wave. Okay, then next, what happened in 1862, James Maxwell. Okay, he put forth the theory that light is an electromagnetic wave. Okay, and then later on 1887, a German physicist, Heinrich Hertz, generated a different kind of electromagnetic wave that is radio wave. Okay, so we take the symbol for the unit for frequency according to his name, Hertz, okay, Heinrich Hertz. Okay, and then in the earlier 20th century, what happened? Electromagnetic waves are made of, okay, other scientists, other physicists has discovered and find out that electromagnetic waves are made of 7 spectrum, okay, which is consists of gamma ray, as said by sine wave just now, and then we have X-ray, ultraviolet ray, visible light, okay, infrared, microwave, and radio wave. So if you talk about electromagnetic wave, these are the 7 spectrum of electromagnetic wave, start from gamma ray until radio wave. Okay, then let's go to the gist of the story. What is electromagnetic wave? Students, this is the definition for electromagnetic wave. So it is a wave, okay, which is made up of combination. It is a combination of electric field and magnetic field, which oscillate perpendicularly to one and another. Okay, if you look at the simulation here, this is how electromagnetic wave produce. So it has two components, electrical component and magnetical component. They oscillate perpendicularly 90 degrees to one and another, producing electromagnetic wave. So if you look from the name, electro means from the electric field. Magnetic is come from the magnetic. So we combine the name, it becomes electromagnetic wave. So in the exam, if they ask you to write what is electromagnetic wave, write the definition for electromagnetic wave. Say the meaning of electromagnetic wave. So this is what you need to write. Okay. It is a wave which made up from electric field and magnetic field that oscillate perpendicularly to one and another. The yellow wording is the keyword for the definition of EM wave. All right. Okay, then next. Okay, so these are seven characteristics of electromagnetic wave. Okay, first one, if from the simulation you see earlier, can you tell me what type of electromagnetic wave is? Is it transverse or longitudinal wave, students? Okay. Transverse or longitudinal? Yes, in the direction of propagation is perpendicular to one and another. Okay, for the electric field and magnetic field. So it is transverse wave. Okay. So the first characteristic, all electromagnetic waves are transverse wave. The seven spectrum, all are transverse wave. Second characteristic, okay. Electromagnetic wave, they do not require any medium for propagation. Okay, they can propagate through vacuum as well, right? So they do not require medium for propagation, so they can propagate even through vacuum. Okay, then the third characteristic, all electromagnetic waves move in a speed of light. Okay, so speed of light, the symbol is C, 3 times 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. All of them, okay, move in the speed of light in vacuum, okay? And when they are moving in a medium, okay, the speed will be lower. Okay, when they are moving in another medium, other medium than vacuum, let's say in air, in water, in the soil or so on, so the speed will be decreases due to the different density or optical density in the medium. Okay, and then the fourth characteristic, all wave propagate, they transfer energy. Yeah, remember when wave propagate, they transfer energy. So same thing goes to this EM wave. They transfer energy when propagating from one point to another. Okay, and then the fifth characteristic, they carry no charge. All EM waves are said to be neutral. Okay, X-ray, gamma ray, infrared, UV ray, they are all neutral, no charge. Okay, then they are all applies the wave equation. Remember, student, you learned earlier wave equation is V equal F lambda, where V is the speed of wave, F is the frequency, lambda is the wavelength. And for electromagnetic wave, since they are all moving with the same speed, so V is rewritten as C equal F lambda. C is what? C is the speed of light. Okay, 3 times 10 power of 8 meter per second. Okay, and then the seven characteristic. All electromagnetic waves, they also show phenomenon of reflection, refraction, diffraction, and interference, similar to sound waves, similar to water waves, similar to any other mechanical or wave. Okay, so are you clear the characteristic of EM wave? Okay, can you remember seven of them from transverse until the phenomenon it shows? Boleh ingat eh? Okay, any questions so far? Okay, are you following me? Okay, remember three. Okay, at least you remember three or four. Ingatlah mana-mana yang senang. Transverse and propagate through vacuum. transfer energy, move at the speed of light in vacuum. Okay, applies wave equation, no charge, show reflection, refraction, diffraction, and interference as well. Okay, very good. Okay, that is the first learning standard done. Okay, we have characterized EM wave. So remember, student, what is EM wave? Combination of electric field and magnetic field, which propagate perpendicularly to one and another. All right. Okay, now let's check on the second learning standard. Okay, so 5.7.2. You have to state the components of the EM wave electromagnetic spectrum according to their wavelength and frequency. Okay, now let's take a look at the breakdown. Okay, earlier, we understand EM wave consists of seven components or seven spectrum. Okay, so these are how the spectrum of the EM wave arrange according to their wavelength and frequency. Okay, so if you look at this diagram and look at the arrow up here, okay, from the left to the right, it shows that the wavelength is increasing. Okay, you can see here the wavelength at this region is shorter. Okay, shorter wavelength. What is wavelength? Distance between two consecutive rests. Okay, here you can see the wavelength is shorter. Okay, this is the wavelength shorter. And moving to the right, you can see that the wavelength is longer. Okay, wavelength is longer. So from gamma ray to radio wave, the wavelength increases. Okay, gamma ray is an EM wave with the shortest wavelength, while radio wave is an EM wave with the longest wavelength. Okay, and if you look at down here, okay, the frequency is reverse or opposite to the wavelength. Okay, gamma ray is an EM wave with the highest frequency. Okay, the frequency here is the highest. So what is frequency? Number of waves produced in one complete oscillation. Okay, so you can see frequency, it produces more number of waves in 1 second. And going to the right, moving to the right, you can see that the frequency decreases. It produces less number of complete waves in 1 second. So in this, we understand that wavelength is inversely proportional to frequency. Students, again, gamma ray is an EM wave with a shortest wavelength but highest frequency. Okay, while radio wave is an EM wave with the longest wavelength but shortest frequency, lowest frequency. Okay. And these are the range of the wavelength, gamma ray. It range in between, so you can see until 10.-11 meter, and then in between 10-11 until 10-8, there lies the X-ray. Okay, so we check from the first one from here. Okay, first radio wave. Okay, this is the wavelength in between 10-1 until 10.4 meter. Okay, the frequency ranging from 10.9, 10.4 until 10.9 hertz. Okay, second we have microwave. Microwave is an EM wave ranging from, this is the wavelength, from 10-4 until 10-1 meter. Okay, and the frequency increases from 10.9 until 10.12, the ranging. Then lies the infrared. Okay, so students, if possible, you have to know the position for each. What comes after what? So radio wave, then next to it is microwave. And next to microwave is infrared. And here we have visible light, okay, number 4. So visible light in me is the light that enable us to see things around us. Okay, in the visible light consists of 7 spectrum of color, from red to violet. Okay, ranging, the wavelength is ranging in between 400 until 750 nanometer. Okay, and then number 5, we have the UV, ultraviolet ray. Okay, the wavelength 10-8 until 10-6.5. okay, while the frequency ranging from 1015 until 1016 hertz. Okay, number six is the X-ray. X-ray wavelength ranging from 10^-11 until 10^-8 meter. Okay, while the frequency ranging in between 1016 until 1019 hertz. Okay, and the last one is gamma ray. Okay, gamma ray number seven. This is the wavelength. It shows up here, and the frequency is started from 1020 above. Okay, onwards. Okay, so this is the how they are arranged in the electromagnetic spectrum. So this is what we call as an electromagnetic spectrum, consists of seven components, started from radio wave with the longest wavelength and lowest frequency, ended with gamma ray with shortest wavelength and highest frequency. Okay, so are you clear with electromagnetic spectrum, students? Okay, do you think you can memorize the position for each radio, micro, infra, visible light, ultraviolet, X-ray, and gamma ray? So by hook or by crook, have to put this in your head. Okay. Okay, that is to do with the second learning standard. Okay. Now in the third learning standard, okay, we 5.7.3. Each and every one of you have to communicate to explain about the application of each component in the EM spectrum in detail. So later on, we are going to go at the breakdown. Okay. What are all these EM waves used for? Okay. Before that, can you please open your workbook on page 155? Okay. Before we proceed with learning standard 3, please take out your workbook. Turn to page 155. Okay, are you there? 155. Okay, students, 154. Okay, first take a look at 154. So we do this together. Okay. So 154, electromagnetic wave, 5.7. Activity A, characteristic of EM wave. Okay, so can you underline the correct word there? Which one is the answer? Can someone read Sinway? Can you read number one? 145, 154. Can you read what?
Yeah. Property of electromagnetic waves is the electric and magnetic sound vibrates perpendicular to each other and in the direction of propagation.
Okay, very good. So you underline perpendicular. Okay, very good. Thank you. Property of EM wave is the electric and magnetic field vibrate perpendicular to each other and in the direction of propagation. Okay, now let's check on number two. Anybody would like to read for number two? Chan Bozer, can you read for number two? 155. Bozer? Or Dennis maybe? Or anyone? Okay, come on for Akit. Number two. Electromagnetic wave are which one? Longitudinal or transverse wave? This is transverse. So you underline transverse wave. Okay. Okay. And then number three, it tells you the properties of electromagnetic wave. So you can see from number one to number eight there. Okay, they break down into eight characteristics in diagram 5.37. Okay, the first one, number one, it transfers energy. Okay, so the energy from the sun, they used to dry up our clothes. Itu example. Okay, number two, electric and magnetic field oscillating at right angle. Right angle mean perpendicular to each other and to direction of travel. Okay, number three, transverse wave. Okay, remember transverse wave, the particle vibrate perpendicular to the direction of motion. Okay, number four, do not require medium for transmission. It can propagate in any medium. That's what it means, even through vacuum. Okay, if you remember, which wave cannot travel through vacuum, students? Which wave cannot travel through vacuum? It is?
Sound wave.
Yeah, very good. Sound wave cannot travel through vacuum, but no problem with it in wave. It can travel or propagate into whole mediums. Okay? So that's why we say it does not require any medium for transmission or propagation. Okay, number five, it travels at the speed of light in vacuum. So this is a speed of light, C, 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. Okay, number six, okay, it shows property of waves such as reflection, refraction, diffraction, and interference. And number seven, they carry no charges. So remember, all EM waves are neutral. Okay, and the last one, number eight, is written there. Wave equation is applicable where V equal to F lambda and V can be replaced with C. Okay, C is speed of light in vacuum. So I hope you're clear with the characteristic. Okay, and then now let us check at the component B of the electromagnetic spectrum. Number one, number two, number three. So you are given a components of EM spectrum arranged in increasing frequency and decreasing wavelength as follow. Okay, so sometimes they put the radio wave on the left, okay, the gamma ray on the right. Sometimes they put it in the other way around. Okay, so if you refer to this page, okay, they put radio wave on left. Increasing frequency means radio wave is the lowest frequency, gamma ray has the highest frequency, and then in decreasing wavelength means that radio wave is the longest wavelength, gamma ray is the shortest wavelength. Okay, so it can be the other way around. Okay, number two, okay, radio wave have the what, student? Shortest or longest wavelength? Radio wave.
Longer.
Yeah, radio wave has the longest wavelength. So you underline longest wavelength, but are of low or high?
Low.
Low frequency wave, okay, overall. Okay, then they carry very low or high energy. They carry low or high energy. Okay, if you check on my slide, okay, down here, the energy carried by EM wave is directly proportional to its frequency. It means that if the wave had a high frequency, it carries high energy. Okay? If the frequency is low, the wave carries a low energy. So this one, low, okay, a high. So low energy since the frequency is low. Okay, how about number three? Gamma rays. Now gamma rays. Gamma rays have the what wavelength? Gamma rays is the shortest. Okay, shortest wavelength. Sound wave, water wave, all bukan neutral. What do you mean? Sound wave all. Dia ada yang ada contoh electric electrical. Kalau electrical wave saja, dia ada charges. Okay. But if combined with electromagnetic, then it becomes neutral in wave. Okay? So gamma ray has the shortest wavelength, but are of high frequency wave. Why gamma have high frequency? Because they either carry high energy. Okay, why energy is high for gamma? Because it has high frequency. Okay? So I hope you're clear the components of the EM wave is which one with the shortest wavelength, highest frequency, and which one is the longest wavelength and lowest frequency. Okay, now let's check on learning standard 3. You don't close your book first because we are going to do together with the slide. Okay, so first take a look at radio wave. Okay, so this is radio wave. This is a signal for radio wave. You can see it is a transverse wave there. And we have AM in the amplitude modulation. Okay, you can see that the amplitude is modified. The frequency is the same for AM. Okay, this kind of radio wave is normally using in the urban area. Kawasan luar bandar, dia banyak guna AM radio wave. Okay, while this one is labeled as FM. Okay, frequency modulated. Okay, the amplitude is the same, but the frequency is varies. Yeah, we use this kind of radio wave mostly in the city, kawasan bandar. You akan dapat dengar channel FM. Okay, so this is radio wave. It is a long distance radio communication. Used for long distance radio communication. Okay, and also used for local radio and TV broadcasting. All right, other than that, it is also applies in wireless communication, for example, a Bluetooth, and then Wi-Fi. Yeah, Zigbee and Z-Wave, ini we does not use in Malaysia, maybe in any other country. Okay, Bluetooth we have, Wi-Fi also we have. And also use as the millimeter wave machine to scan the body of the passenger at the airport. So if you used to be travel anywhere by airplane, they scan the body of the passenger using a millimeter wave machine, applies radio wave. Okay, so that goes with the first one, radio wave. So students can look at your exercise book, 155, part C, applications of EM wave. Okay, I want you to write, complete the source and application. Okay, the source. Where does radio wave coming from, the sources? So you write there, electrical oscillating circuit. And that is the sources producing radio wave. Electrical oscillating circuit. Okay, inside the radio component. And then for the application, you can write A, telecommunication. Now, all these are telecommunication. Radio and TV, we call it as telecommunication. And then B, you can write broadcasting, TV, and radio transmission. Okay? Are you following me? Did you get the point? I repeat, the sources for radio wave, it is from electrical oscillating circuit. Okay, how to spell circuit, C-I-R-C-U-I-T. Application, you can write telecommunication, and then second, broadcasting, TV, and radio transmission. Or you can write any one listed here. So you can take a screenshot if possible. Later, you can fill up. Okay, and then we go to the next part. And then we have microwave. Okay, microwave, you can turn to page 156. A microwave, okay, it is used in the international communication through satellite. Okay, satellite using microwave. Okay, then also used in a mobile phone framework. So your smartphone itu dia guna microwave. Okay, when you call someone or sending messages using any application in your smartphone, it is actually using microwave. And also using in a communication between electronic devices, such as Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, Zigbee, and TV. Ini yang tadilah. Okay. And then also the detection of plane radar and speed trap. Okay. So radar system are using microwave. Okay. Either radar system for military or for the airplane. Okay. In a transportation and also a speed trap in the highway. Ini biasa tengok kan speed trap. Okay. Then what else? It is also used for cooking using microwave oven. Okay, so talking about oven, we have two types of oven. First oven is using microwave, so we call it microwave oven. Another one, we have the ordinary oven, which is using electrical current, okay, to operate for infrared. Okay, so where is the sources of microwave? The sources you can write, oscillating electrical charge in a microwave transmitter. Okay, I type here. This is the sources for microwave, oscillating electrical charge in a microwave transmitter. Okay, so this is the sources of microwave. Okay, you can check the answer on the info messages. I type there for you. So application, you can write satellite transmission. Okay, this is satellite transmission, and then radar detection. Okay, radar detector, and also in hooking. Okay, A, satellite transmission, B, radar detector, and C, you can write hooking. Okay, 1, 2, 3, ini is satellite transmission. This one is radar detector, and the third one is hooking. Okay, so are you done with microwave, students? Okay, did you get the point for microwave, saucers, and application? Anyone?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. So I guess you are doing good there. Okay, now we check on the third. Okay, the third spectrum, infrared. Okay, Nicholas MC. He's not feeling well. You know, wonder I didn't hear his voice. Okay, then infrared. Okay, students, infrared. Okay, so infrared I use where? Number one, use for cooking. Okay, this is an ordinary oven, not a microwave oven. Okay, a cooking oven, grill, and toaster. They all using infrared. So when you turn on your gas stove and in the kitchen, actually it produces infrared. Anything that produces heat produces infrared. Even our body produces infrared. Okay, when our body temperature is high, so we produce a less portion of infrared. And then it is also used for night vision camera and binoculars. As you can see here, okay, ini gamers lah, contoh example. Okay, and then infrared also used for drying paint on car. Kalau you tengok in a workshop, they dry the paint for a car using infrared. Okay, after they spray the paint, and then they will expose it to an infrared in a certain room. Infrared also used in a treatment of muscle pain. Okay, it can relieve the muscle pain, and also used in a remote control for devices such as TV and DVD player. So when you press on your remote control at home, you can see it produce infrared. Okay, there's a red blinking there on the remote control. Okay, so students, where is the sources of infrared? So you write the sources: hot body, sun, fires. Okay, hot body, body to refer to any object. Okay, so the sources I type there, hot bodies. Bodies ini not only refer to human bodies, but in physics, object we call as body. Okay, any object we call it as bodies. Okay, the sun and fire. Okay, so this is the sources producing infrared. Any hot object, the sun and fire. Okay. Application, you can see cooking, okay, night vision. This is physiotherapy, okay, muscle pain, and also in remote control. Okay, or you can write anyone stated here. Tulislah sekurang-kurangnya tiga, okay. Write at least three application for each. Cooking, night vision, treatment of muscle pain, or we call it as physiotherapy, and also in remote control. Right? Okay, are you done with infrared?
Yes.
Okay, and now let's proceed on visible light. Okay, so visible light, it consists of 7 spectrum of light, which is coming from one white light. Okay, it can spread into 7 spectrum, namely as red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. Okay, the one which we see as a rainbow. Okay, so visible light is the light which enable us to see things. Okay, you boleh melihat, you buka mata, you nampak objek, you can see your parents, you can see your house, you can see everything around you because there is a visible light. Okay, second, it is used in photography. also used in photosynthesis in green plants. A, without light, photosynthesis cannot occur. And laser light. Okay, laser light is also a visible light, which is used in cutting of metal, as seen here, shows here. And then measurement of length, and also for sending information through optical fibers. So this is optical fiber. Okay, this is how they use laser to cutting metals, and this is how the optical fiber laser. Okay, optical fiber. Okay, then, what are the sources producing visible light? Okay, where does the light coming from, students? Visible light. Okay, the major sources. The major sources is from the sun. Okay, the major sources from the sun, and also from hot objects. Okay, you can write there hot objects, light bulb. Okay, light bulb producing light also, light bulb, and then fluorescent tube. Okay. So all these producing visible light, major sources is from the sun. It is also coming from any hot objects, light bulb, and fluorescent tube. Okay. Application, this one is called sight. Okay. Sight, kita punya penglihatan. Okay. Photosynthesis in plant. Okay. And you can write there photography. Okay, or you can write there optical fibers. Okay, laser for cutting metal, or you can say laser for measurement of length and sending information through optical fibers. So at least you write three applications. Okay, and then next, okay, what do we have next? We have ultraviolet. Okay, ultraviolet ray. So what does ultraviolet ray use for? Number one, it is used to harden tooth filling material. So when you go to the dentist, when you fix your teeth, your decay teeth, so the doctor will use the UV ray, okay, to harden the tooth filling material. Nak bagi dia keras. Bila you pergi tampal gigi, dia tampal dengan sejenis bahan, then to make the thing harden, so they expose ultraviolet ray into it. Okay, and then UV ray also used to determine the originality, or we call as the authenticity of the currency note. Nak kesan duit ini betul ke ataupun fake? Betul ke ataupun duit palsu? Okay, so they are using UV ray. They scan the money below the UV ray. And then it is also used in the treatment of jaundice in baby. Okay, you know jaundice? Anyone? Jaundice in baby, where the baby appear to be yellow, you look yellow, the skin to be yellowish, the eye also yellowish, because a problem in the liver. The liver cannot work in a proper way, so it causes jaundice in baby. So they will expose the baby under UV light for certain period, okay, to reduce the jaundice. Okay, and then it is also used in the purification of drinking water. Okay, UV ray plus sterilizing surgical or medical instrument, and also in the food processing technology, so that the food can last longer. Okay, and also apply in insect trap. You biasa tengok tak perangkap lalat yang dia pasang pada keran. Okay, it produces ultraviolet ray. So where is the sources of UV ray, students? UV ray coming from where? UV ray. Okay, the major sources is again from the sun. And also it is coming from a very hot object. Okay, and also from mercury vapor lamp. Okay, so all these producing UV ray. If you go to the hospital, the surgical room, it does not use a normal light, but they are using UV lamp. Okay, so it is to sterilize the surgical operation or the surgical room, okay, by using UV light. Okay, so next, what do we have? X-ray. Okay. Anybody used to conduct X-ray before? Normally, when you do medical checkup, if you want to further your study in a college or in the university, okay, you need to do an X-ray as one part of the medical checkup. Okay, so this X-ray, the sources is from X-ray tube. Okay, the sources of X-ray is from X-ray tube. Okay, I type it in the info messages. And X-ray is used for what? Okay. Number one is to detect fractures or broken bones and to examine our internal organ. This is very normal usage. Okay, the first usage of X-ray. Second, it is also used on checking of welding connection and also can also detect a connection in pipe. Okay, they are using X-ray if there is any defects there. Okay, X-ray also used in a baggage scanning at the airport, as you can see at the simulation given here. Okay, and number four, it is used to determine the authenticity of paintings. Okay, lukisan. Mereka jual lukisan sangat mahal, thousand over million. So to check either the painting is authentic, original or not. For example, the Mona Lisa portrait, you want to solve it, painted by Leonardo da Vinci. So they can detect the authenticity by using X-ray. Okay. And next, so you can write any three applications in your workbook. Number one, detect fracture or broken bones. Okay. Second, checking on welding connection. Okay. Number three, baggage scanning. Okay. And number four, determine authenticity of paintings. Okay, so that goes for X-ray. Other than checking of welding connection, we are also use X-ray to detect any crack in the building or in the bridge structure. Okay, so later on, if any one of you become an architect or civil engineer, you will apply this in checking the buildings and bridges which constructed maybe under you. Okay, next, students, we have gamma ray. Okay, the last one, gamma ray. Okay, so gamma ray, where is the sources of gamma ray, students? So gamma ray, ini is a radioactive ray. Okay, so it is coming from radioactive sources. Okay, gamma ray, ini coming from radioactive sources. Can you give me a few examples of sources producing gamma ray? Anyone? Example of chemical or radioactive chemical or radioactive sources producing gamma ray? Any idea? Okay, for example, cobalt 60, lupa, tak apa, cobalt 60, for example, cobalt 60 is used in treating cancer patient which produce gamma ray. Okay, cobalt 60, saya bagi satu contoh lah, okay, cobalt 60. Okay, cobalt 60 ini dia adalah radioisotopes, okay, which is used in treating cancer patient. So this cobalt 60 producing gamma ray. Okay, then, what is gamma ray used for? Number one, it is used to kill cancer cell in radiotherapy, okay, to treat cancer patient. Okay, so you can write cancer treatment enough, okay, for the application. Number one, cancer treatment. Then second, gamma ray also used in a sterilization of surgical and medical equipment in the bag secara besar-besaran, okay, to sterilize surgical and medical equipment. So you can write this as the second application. Okay. And then number three, it is used in food processing industry so they can last longer, especially canning food. Okay. If you buy canned food at the supermarket, you can see the expiry date normally for up to 3 to 4 years. Okay. 3 to 4 years. as long as you didn't open it, so it can last, okay, for 3 to 4 years, because it has been exposed to the gamma ray to inhibit the growth of a microorganism inside the food. Okay. And then number four, sorry. Again, other than this, we are also using gamma ray in pest control in agriculture. Boleh tambah lagi satu. Untuk mengawal serangga perosak dalam bidang pertanian. Okay. Pest control in agriculture. You boleh tambah lagi satu. Pest control in agriculture. Awalan makhluk perosak dalam bidang pertanian. Okay. So that goes for gamma ray. Together the sources, together with the application. So I hope by this you have completed the table in C, applications of electromagnetic wave in your workbook, page 155 until 156. Okay? Okay, students. And now I have a question for you. So we have done with the lesson. Habis saja, habis 5.7. Okay, pendek saja. Very simple. Okay, now can we check on page 156? Okay, test yourself in me. There's a few questions I want you to try. Number one here, you have to list three characteristics of EM waves. So try to list them out of 7 or out of 8 given before. And then in here, you are given this diagram showing the EM component radio wave until L here. First, you have to state J, K, and L. And together, give one use of each in our daily life. Bagi satu saja kegunaan. Okay? And then B, what is the relationship between the frequency and the energy of the EM wave? Okay, nanti you tolong buat latihan ini eh. Okay, and then this one, a few questions on SPM corner. You try to do first. I will discuss all the answer in the next lesson. Okay, ini number four. Ada 10 altogether, they are 10 objective questions and one essay question for you to try on. Okay, diagram show communication system involved in transmitting information between two distant locations. So the problem here, the wave is transmitted from the transmitter received by the receiver is not clear. So the signal sent and received is not clear. So you are required to give some suggestion to design a communication system which can improve the quality of the signal transmission. So they give you this guidance. Okay? Using your knowledge on wave, explain your suggestion based on these 5 aspects. So you have to tell what type of wave transmitted. Okay? So just now we discussed in satellite communication, what type of wave we are using. And then why? Frequency of the wave, need to be high or need to be low? Why? Diameter of the receiver, need to be big or need to be small? Why? And what is the method involved which enable the wave to be propagated in longer distance? And the fifth one, location of the transmitter and receiver, where to place at? Okay, it's a very simple essay. So I want you to give a try on them first before I share to you the answer in the next lesson. Okay, anything you would like to ask? Ada apa nak tanya? Okay, we have 4 minutes left. So can we go to page 156, students? Uji kendiri 5.7. Okay, there are one question there, A, B, and C. Okay, A, B, and C. It's a very simple exercise there. So let us try them together. Okay, 156, uji kendiri 5.7. Diagram show electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, the diagram shows the electromagnetic spectrum. You can see R on the left side, followed by X-ray, and then ultraviolet, visible light, infrared, microwave, radio wave. So what is R, students, in A? State, electromagnetic wave R. So what is the name of R?
Gamma ray.
Yeah, gamma ray, very good. So you write there, gamma ray, double M, G-A-M-M-A, gamma ray. How about B? Anybody would like to try? Give one reason why microwave is used in satellite communication. Okay, anyone?
Long wavelength.
Yeah, come again.
Long wavelength and
long wavelength, very good. Long wavelength. Any other reason? So you can write long wavelength, so easily diffracted. Okay, easily diffracted. Long wavelength, so easily diffracted. Okay, how about C? Okay, C. A radio station emits radio wave at the frequency of 100. 100 what? MHz to stand for? 100. Capital M itu apa? Radio station emits radio wave at the frequency of 100. Capital M itu apa? That is... Ini prefixes, okay, prefixes. Mega, okay, megahertz. What is the power for mega, students? So you have to state the frequency in the unit of hertz. Hertz is the unit for frequency. And now the prefixes is mega, 100 megahertz. So can you state 100 megahertz in unit of hertz only? So we have 100 megahertz. So this is conversion of unit. 100 megahertz, it means 100 times 10 to the power of 6 hertz. Okay, ini the frequency. So is this the standard unit? Kita perlu selesaikan lagi. So we place 1.0 times 10 to the power of 8 hertz. Okay, so this is how we convert from megahertz into hertz. So answer is 1 times 10 to the power of 8 hertz. Okay, simple conversion only. Kalau dia bagi macam ini, ini maksud apa? Small m, small m ini refers to, small m ini refers to milli, millihertz. They say they give you 100 millihertz. So this one is 100 times 10 negative 3 hertz. Okay. So if you convert to hertz, so it become 1 times 10 negative 1 hertz. Okay. So this is the difference. Milli, this is mega. Okay. So how about number two, C2? Okay, one question before we dismiss. Calculate the wavelength of the radio wave when given the speed 3 times 10 to the power of 8. So what is the formula we are applying here for C2, students? C2, to find... Yeah, we are using... You can use V equal F lambda. For V, ini can be C. Okay, C equal F lambda. So, the speed is given. So, we are looking for the lambda wavelength. So, you arrange. So, lambda is given by V or C divide F. Okay, so this one 3 times 10 to the power of 8. So, divide with the frequency in hertz. 1 times 10 power of 8. So, what is the answer? Ini semua sama kan? Ini sama. So 3 divide by 1, it is 3 meter. Okay. So the wavelength is 3 meter. Okay. So I hope you're clear with that. So please try to do with the exercises in this module. I will share the answer in the next lesson. Okay. Anything else? So thank you very much for your attendance. Thank you for your cooperation. I really appreciate that. So see you in the next lesson. Bye-bye for now. And all the best for the next subject.